privilege for me to be here in the midst of all of you. Great pleasure because I've been closely associated with all of you in the direct selling industry. My belief always has been that the direct selling industry adds hugely to economic activity. It is a major driver of India's growth, and that it provides economic impetus to any more than anything else. And the key challenge for India is really about growth with jobs. So if you are not able to create jobs, then we'll be in deep problems. And therefore, jobs are very, very critical. And this industry creates jobs. And important thing is that we need to create jobs for women. We need to create jobs for women because in India, the contribution of women to gross domestic product, that is our GDP, is only 17%. And worldwide average is around 40%. 40%, the gap between India and the rest of the world is enormous. 24% of women in India work, but the contribution is only 17%. And unless and until we don't, as a conscious policy, have gender parity, there are many more women to become economic drivers of growth, it'll be very difficult for India to grow. And actually, if you're able to create gender parity, have 40% women working, we'll be adding $700 billion to India's GDP.
Wow.
So while we are growing at 7.6%, we need to grow at 9 to 10% per annum for 3 decades or more to be able to create jobs for a very young population. We are passing through a window of demographic transition, which rarely happens in history. Our population is very young. You know, the biggest social and economic transition that is taking place across the world is the fact that the population in Europe and America is getting older and older. The population in India is getting younger and younger, and it'll keep getting younger till 2040. And therefore, if you have to reap this advantage, it can be a huge nightmare as well if you are not able to create jobs. So if you have to create jobs, there are only two ways. One is to push manufacturing in a very big way, and the other is to push direct selling. So that many of you create jobs, you should also be able to do, you know, right now many of you don't, many of you were seen as people who were doing chit funds. You are not doing chit funds. You know, you are doing a very respectable profession. You are economic drivers of growth for India. So we respect that. And that has now been recognized. That has now been recognized that you are, government has, by issuing these guidelines, clearly recognized that you are major players of India's economy, that you significantly contribute to India's economy, that you are adding to India's growth and wealth, and that you are creating jobs. And therefore, getting out with these guidelines were very important. And these guidelines have now been given to different states to realize that you are important players in India's economy. And every state will respect these guidelines because they've been issued by government of India. But as we go along, I think we'll probably work towards a legislation which will clearly spell out what is direct selling. So we'll work towards that in the long run, and I think we'll totally legitimize all this. So my view is that a lot of wrong was done against some of you in the past. We've forgotten that. We should look at the future. We should look at growth. And therefore, all of you will be very, very critical, very major drivers of growth of India. And as I've said, our objective is to try and make India extremely easy and simple. We are working towards that. The issuing of these guidelines is also one of the flares, but we are working towards, we've done the bankruptcy law. We've created Jan Dhan accounts for a lot of people. We have now working towards creation, you know, this whole process of financial inclusion of people, working towards Jandan accounts, working towards bank correspondence, working towards doing away with, the intention of this entire demonetization process is that India must move from a cash economy, which is 86% of India.